YouTubers. Hello, YouTubers, and welcome to this T4D. So by the title of the T4D, you'll see I'm actually going to sell most of my test equipment that I've got in my lab. So I'm going to give you the background behind that story and why and when that's going to happen. I'm going to be taking the next couple of weeks off just for a bit of a break. It's summer here in the States. It's been a bit of a manic year and it's been a little bit of a testing year. So I'm going to take a bit of a break, and when I come back, there's going to be a little bit of a change in the way I do things, which is what I'm going to discuss in this video as well. I also have, what I'm going to do is a review on some really nice older measurement equipment that I got. So these 2 meters are from General Electric. One's a watt meter, one's an AC current meter. These are from the 40s and the 50s. I got from Chris Gammel of Contextual Electronics. And then I also got this really, really cool analog clamp meter. It's called a triplet, and this I got from Ben of the Burb Billy, his channel. You'll know he's a handyman who came and worked for me, and he started his own channel reviewing tools and the like. He put this in my hands. I was having a drink with him, so I'll have a quick look at this and then I'll review these in the future. So let me bring you up to speed with what's happening. I'm sure you'll have noticed that the frequency of my videos has decreased radically. Couple of reasons for that. I've been busy trying to grow the content on my website, and the big drive here is to ask people please to support me on my website. I'm going to show you what content is being grown there. Steve's been doing a brilliant job, but it's taken a fair bit of his time and a bit of my time as well. And then also, I face challenges in terms of income and running my channel. And I'm literally, after this 2 week break, unless something miraculous happens, I'm gonna have to step away from doing this full time to a part-time gig, because I need to supplement the income. So that is the key reason for the sell-off of the equipment. This year, if you've followed some of the other T4Ds, have been a challenge in terms of what happened on my website early in the year. That was a big stymie for me. Also, my sponsor didn't renew, and the advertising rates on Google have plummeted. So I've discussed this with a few other YouTubers, and for them it's been the same. Certainly for me, since 2013, the rates are a quarter of what they were. So even though my views have steadily increased, the rate has dropped by only a quarter of what it was in 2013. So my revenue has just plummeted. And I can no longer afford to do this full time and actually pay the bills. So I'm gonna go perhaps reinvent myself and find another alternate source of income. I'm still gonna be doing videos, and what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna concentrate on the DIY projects and tutorials. The equipment reviews, I've actually told manufacturers for the most part, hold off, don't send me anything. I still have a few odd bits and bobs on the bench which I haven't reviewed yet. So in between tutorials and the projects, I'll throw in the odd review of kit that I haven't looked at and the older kit, and a look inside some of the bits and pieces. I'm also going to run a viewer survey. There'll be a nice little giveaway with that survey. So when I come back, so I'll have a questionnaire and survey posted on my website. And you'll be able to go there and ask questions like, what is the easiest way for you to support me? What kinds of videos do you like? There'll be some fun questions in there as well, where you can provide feedback. So at least then going forward, I can understand what you as a viewer are after. I also plan to get into more niche stuff, which I'm really passionate about, and that is solar power. I want to finish off the build of my solar power simulator. I just haven't had the time with what's happened this year to finish that off. Are to either prove whether it's going to be viable or not to build your own indoor simulator, and tied up with that is going to be the tutorial on how solar panels work, where we're going to look at literally at an atomic level how power is generated on solar panels, the band gap, how different materials react to different bands of light, because that is the information that I've been looking at in order for me to build this sunlight simulator. And in that regard, I also want to kind of specialize in a series of videos on my website where I go and look at the best solar panels, whether it's to power your home, a shed, or an RV. Then in terms of energy storage, what type of battery technology or supercapacitor technology that's going to work with. There are a lot of new things coming out in the market in terms of lithium battery banks, the Tesla Powerwall, and from what I can see, there isn't much consumer information or testing showing which one is the best for what situation. So that's the kind of testing I want to get into, and that I'm going to do separately on my website. So there's some interesting changes ahead. It's going to be very interesting for me to adopt this new approach to doing things. Certainly, if there are companies out there which do want their product branding on my videos, that will certainly change things up. If I can do that and I have enough income from either that or advertising on my website or forum, that would certainly help. And in that way, then I can increase the frequency of the videos that I do. But let me take you to have a quick look at my website and what Steve's been doing there. And then I'll give you a quick overview of these meters on the bench. And just before we get to my website, for a quick laugh, my good wife sent me this article which appeared on the BBC website that Microsoft had paid out $10,000 for a Windows 10 update. So many of you may realize, if you've been sitting on previous versions of Windows, that Microsoft have been really sneakily and almost trying to force people into a Windows 10 update. And I tweeted and shared on my social media not too long ago about Steve Gibson and his Never 10. I'll place a link below if you want to stop the Windows 10 update from the nagging and removing the install files. You just run that and you won't have it. Because like many others, I initially thought I might want to go to Windows 10. So I said, yes, I'd be open to the option. And then when I heard it came out and I heard all the tracking and I thought, and the change of the interface, I thought, no, I don't really want it. I'm happy with Windows 7 at the time being, but then just couldn't get rid of the nags. So this is very interesting that Microsoft have gone and paid out because they didn't want to go to court, because they forced someone to go to Windows 10 and it disrupted this woman's business. Another reason I give this is I've literally in this last week, and I cannot pin it down to whether it was a Microsoft update, so not a Windows 10 update, but one of their security updates, it crashed my OS drive. And although I'm very good with backups and everything else, it took me longer to recover than I had hoped, but I have fully recovered. But it looks like a Windows update went and crashed my PC as well. But anyway, let's get onto the website. So Steve has been doing a brilliant job. We have been kind of growing the interface and hoping to make it as easy to use as possible. Steve certainly says, please, if there are any comments or improvements that you would like to see, then you can email me and I'll pass this on to Steve. We have tried to make it as easy as possible in terms of if you want to support me, there are many ways in which you can support me. So if you click on the support tab, the one thing is I would say, if you can, if you run an ad blocker, disable it for my site. We don't do any silly advertising or pop-ups. It's very unobtrusive. It's either on the top of the page or down the side. If you do want to keep up to date with what I'm doing in the lab, there are many things which are happening in the lab which I'm going to start posting on Google+ and Twitter. I do that anyway. If I find interesting things, I'll share them on Google+ and Twitter and also my Facebook page. And so you can keep up to date there. And then do consider sharing on whatever social media platform that you do. The other big ways to support me are either Patreon, and there's a Patreon link down here. You can go to Patreon and literally $1 per video is all I need. If enough people did that, that would also be a big saver for me. Or you can donate via PayPal. You can either do a one-time donation or you can do a monthly recurring donation. And there's always an easy way to unsubscribe from that. The other way is through my Amazon store. So there are multiple links on my site where you can either go to specific products, my kind of A store, or the link up here will take you to just general Amazon where you can buy anything and I'll be credited for that. You don't pay any more. It's just a commission that I get. And then potentially soon I'm going to have links where you can buy things off eBay. So the Amazon thing is more specific to the USA. But soon I'll have eBay partner links here where you can go buy things off eBay and also support me that way. In terms of content, the DIY section has all the little DIY projects. So the power supply project, the AC to DC power adapter, the ham radio antenna, and then my Go Pack, which I built many years ago. The test and measurement section has got all my multimeter review videos. And what we're doing on that over the next coming weeks and months is pulling out all the data that I've gleaned from the reviews in terms of specs, build quality, safety, and we're going to categorize these meters so that you can choose whether you want a hobbyist one, an industrial one, or a high precision meter. So this is that multimeter database, which I've been threatening to do for ages, is now coming to fruition. We've already started working on that. And under this test and measurement section, there's going to be a table where you can see a review video and then all the specifications across all the meters that I've gone and reviewed. Do consider supporting my advertisers. These are the guys who are keeping things afloat at the moment in terms of me being able to produce videos and content. So there's Rheingold Heavy, there's Michael's site where you can go and do free Arduino courses or sign up for a longer course if you want. And then Chris Gamel has got his contextual electronics. And of course, Steve, my web developer. If you want any web development done, then certainly do consider getting in touch with Steve. So let's quickly chat about the test equipment I plan to sell. There's two key reasons for that. For one is definitely financial at this point in time, because my video blogging is not bringing in enough income for me to do this full time. I am going to sell off the equipment to kind of pay down a little loan that I've got, and that'll extend the time that I'm able to video blog. I'll always produce videos on the side, but in terms of the frequency, that's the challenge. If I'm not able to earn an income from it, I do need to go find an income from another means. If I don't find another sponsor for either the branding on my videos or more advertisers on my website. So I'm going to sell the equipment off for that reason. The other is another one, and I was actually chatting, Chris was talking about this and it was a great idea, is by selling off the equipment, there are two things. For one, what equipment will I be left with? I know frequently I can sit there and go, oh, I want to demonstrate this, or I want to measure this, and I can go grab something and I've generally obviously got it. But what if you're just starting out and you need the basic equipment? And of course, I would be out of touch now with what basic equipment you'd need just to get by and build a basic project, because I'm very fortunate in what I have. So by selling this all off, I'm going to see with what key equipment I would actually keep, the few bits and pieces I feel that are essential for me to continue building the bits and pieces that I'm going to. And then to go and say, well, perhaps this piece of equipment was either too high end and this piece was too low end. If I sell those, what piece would I purchase to replace that? So I've got one single item which does a job which is both cost effective, it's got all the functionality, and it's safe to use. So that's what I plan to do. And maybe even on my website, I then put in packages for like a starter package of what you want on your bench in terms of right from a soldering iron, the multimeter, and a power supply, and then a basic oscilloscope to be able to do a few bits and pieces. So for me, there are a few key pieces that I know I have to keep. For instance, working on the solar power project, the spectrometer I've got is critical for that. So there are a few key pieces like that I'm going to keep, but for the rest, I'm going to sell it. So after the break, I'll put them up my website and people can start, I plan to auction things off, just like eBay basically. So if you're keen to grab some pieces of equipment ahead of time perhaps, then certainly email me. It's going to take me time to pull everything together. So if you know there's a key piece of equipment that I reviewed that you're really interested in and I haven't yet put it up there, you can email me and say, I'm really interested in that, make me an offer. So I'll accept all fair offers on the equipment. The equipment will be sold way below the normal retail, but I also need to make a fair price out of it, obviously, to recoup some of that income. So that'll be happening after the break. But anyway, let me quickly go onto the bench and just show you these lovely old pieces of test and measurement equipment, which I'll review in the coming months. So this first piece Ben of the Burr Billy kindly gave to me, or I'd say is on loan to me. It's very delicate. I'm not sure the age. It does have an original manual, so we'll open that up now and see if there is an age in there. So this is an analog multimeter slash clamp meter. You can see it's very old. The insulation on the bits of test wiring is kind of cracked away. This piece is detachable. So if you do this, you've actually got a clamp meter that you can separate. I was absolutely amazed when I saw this, because I certainly hadn't realized anything like this was about. It has the original leather case. It's got a set of test leads in here, which I'm not going to pull out at the moment. You can see how aged they are and delicate they are, but I'll do that when we do the full review. This one, as you can see, happens to have obviously a previous owner's name. And then there is the original manual. And it's actually got on here, it says,
it cost a quarter, so 25 US cents for the manual only. So this is the triplet, the Mighty Might VOM, and this is the 310 VOM. So this quotes, it's a 10 AC ampere adapter and model 101 line separation adapter. And this is absolutely classic. I'm just going to look and see if anywhere in here, I've not so far come across anything which indicates the date, and I've just not had the time to do a lot of research on this meter, but when we come to review it, we'll certainly go and investigate and see what date this was produced and when they were sold. But a really nice piece of equipment. A big thanks to Ben, the Burb Billy. I really appreciate him. Please go and support his channel as well. And then Chris Gamel was doing a clear out of his home. And this is a General Electric alternating current ammeter. This, the date, if I read it correctly, I think it's 1954. It comes in this brilliant box. I mean, obviously test equipment just isn't made like this these days. Beautiful old Bakelite. And if I remember correctly, this does have a little sticker on the side. I'll just show you. The lid actually slides off. I actually just slide it back on. And on the side, you can see it's got a note of when the last calibration was done back in 1971, and it was due at the end in October of 1971. So a beautiful example of what was produced way back when. And then there's this General Electric watt meter. It's a single phase one. And again, we'll go all over all of this when we actually do the review. But this one is dated the 22nd of September, 1947. And this one, as far as I can tell, doesn't have any other, it's got a, what I assume is a serial number there on the back, but it doesn't have any other calibration information. This one, the handle is in one piece. On the other one, you might, don't know if you saw, the handle is actually almost broken off, but obviously these are really, really old. So I look forward to carefully looking at these and connecting them up, and we'll see if they still work. But what beautiful examples from years gone by.
Right, so that's it. So hopefully some interesting days ahead. I'll now be able to go at my own pace because I've told equipment manufacturers basically to hold off on sending me equipment. I can now spend time working on the projects at my own pace. I can work on the power supply project. I can work on my solar power simulator project. I can do tutorials at my own pace. But I still definitely need the support to be able to do that. So if you can go to my website and consider ways of supporting me, it doesn't necessarily mean having to hand over money. It just means either supporting those people who are advertising on my website or using my Amazon store. After this break, I'll put up that user survey on my website. I'll certainly announce it's there. There will be a random giveaway for all those who participate in the survey. There'll be the questions which kind of ask what kind of videos, what kind of way of supporting me, some interesting fun questions on what you'd like to see or changes or what have you. And we'll do that, I say, after the next couple of weeks. And then the multimeter database and the content on the website, that will continue to grow. So that's where I'm going to put my effort. There'll be some of the videos on YouTube, but then a lot of the content is going to be grown on my website. But anyway, thanks very much, and I'll catch you soon for the next video. Cheers.